Hello everyone, my name is Pranav Kshatriya. I am a physiotherapist working in a private clinic and I am from Gujarat. Now today my topic for discussion will be physiotherapy assessment and treatment after prostate cancer. First of all, we will go through background. The various treatment options for managing prostate cancer all come with a disabling side effects, and physiotherapy intervention can be beneficial for men in managing these side effects. Physiotherapists can help with pelvic floor muscle problems as well as in the management of urinary incontinence and sexual dysfunction. It has been shown that only a fifth of a man will discuss issues of their sexual dysfunction with their healthcare practitioner after prostate cancer. The development of strong therapeutic relationship is beneficial in making sure that patient will comfortable and at ease. A private treatment room, preferably soundproof, will allow the patient to disclose sensitive information. Now, education. Issues around the pelvic floor, incontinence and sexual dysfunction can be very overwhelming, and education around the condition is very helpful. Now, we can use the questionnaires. The use of the questionnaire may provide a non-threatening strategy for a patient to voice their presenting symptoms. There are two questionnaires which can help in prostate cancer or for evaluating for prostate cancer, that are Expanded Prostate Cancer Index Composite, that is EPIC, and International Index of Erectile Function, IIEF, are both validated instruments. Now, subjective examination. For subjective examination, we must undergo through complete history. We will start from current history, and they have to ask about specific intervention, the dosage of radiotherapy the patient has undergone, and now which were spared during a radical prostatectomy. Then past history, we have to ask about any pain, erectile dysfunction or incontinence happened before, or a history of any spinal pain, hip pain or pelvic pain. Medication, it is also known as pharmacological history. Specific medicines for erectile dysfunction the patient was taking before or is taking regularly, or any herbal products. And bladder diary identify the patient pattern or urination as well as leakage. Now we have to ask about sexual dysfunction. Sexual dysfunction after prostate cancer treatment is very common, and men can be uncomfortable talking about the specific issues. There are various numerous symptoms of sexual dysfunction which is responsible for skin, or which can help for screening erectile dysfunction. I will give you some example. For example, orgasmic dysfunction, premature, rapid, early or delayed ejaculation, etc. Now, dietary, we have to ask about dietary habits. Men may restrict fluid to try and prevent leaking, but this can result in more concentrated urine that can irritate the bladder and subsequently can affect frequency, urgency, or it can cause urge incontinence. Pelvic floor pain. Continuous spasm in the pelvic floor muscle can result in persistent nociceptive pain or injury to the surrounding nerves, and can result in neuropathic pain. Focus questioning around the type of pain, area of pain, aggravating and easing factor, as well as 24-hour patterns can help to determine the source of the painful symptoms, means the cause of the painful symptoms. Now, we will jump to the objective assessment of the physical examination. External observation, we can use digital rectal examination, and now recently real-time abdominal ultrasound testing is also helpful. Now, we will directly go to the treatment. There are three main goals of physiotherapy for prostate cancer patient are education, rehabilitation and referral. Now, general management of the incontinence. For radical prostatectomy patient who will most likely to develop initial incontinence after surgery, it can be helpful preoperatively prepare them for the use of pads after his catheter is removed postoperatively. Now, clothing. Simple advice such as wearing darker color shorts or long pants that may not show fluid can also be helpful in case of an accident of leakage of urine. What to drink and what not to. Certain fluids and foods can attribute to the worsening of the symptoms. For example, coffee, green tea and beer are the example of the fluid that may increase the symptoms of incontinence. Now, for general sexual rehabilitation. Of course, for sexual rehabilitation, it is a multidisciplinary approach. It involves a complex process which involves pharmacological, physical and behavioral treatment, and needs to be undertaken by properly, appropriately trained professionals. use of medication to attend an erection promotes good circulation and tissue health in the penis. We can also use vacuum, or we can also prescribe vacuum erection device. It encourages the blood flow to the penis and maintains the connective tissue extensibility as well as the smooth muscle integrity. 50% of the men suffer from depression 1 year after their prostate surgery, and 50% of the patients undergoing radiotherapy have erectile dysfunction after 5 years. So, a diagnosis of cancer in itself a significant cause of psychological distress. So, psychological counseling is one of an important aspect of the treatment after prostate cancer. Now, we have for pelvic floor muscle rehabilitation. Recent research by Stafford et al. 2016 showed that verbal cues can alter the degree of motion observable in various pelvic floor muscles. As you all know, there are three types of pelvic floor muscle training or pelvic floor muscle exercise: contract, relax, fold, relax, and elevator exercise. I will not go in deep because you all know that how to perform the exercise and what to dosage, what is the dosage and all. Stafford et al. Conducted a study in an asymptomatic participant and patients suffering from the continence. The cues shortened the penis and stopped the flow of the urine were considered the best to target the specific muscle involved in urinary incontinence. Now, preoperative pelvic floor exercise. Strengthening the pelvic floor muscle before a prostatectomy was shown to significantly improve post-prostatectomy urinary incontinence, post-micturition dribble, and erectile function. One study reported that 18% of the patients who received preoperative pelvic floor muscle rehab before their prostate surgery reported sexual bother at 1 year versus 66% of the men who did not receive preoperative pelvic floor muscle rehabilitation. Pelvic floor muscle training for erectile dysfunction. Physiotherapy has repeatedly been proved successful in treating erectile dysfunction of various etiologies. It is cost effective, non-invasive and straightforward, and could be used as a first-line approach. A weak pelvic floor as well as a pelvic floor in spasm can both contribute to erectile dysfunction. It means they are the causes of the erectile dysfunction, or it can be considered as one of the reasons for erectile dysfunction. Now, what are the strategies to treat it? Improving the strength of the ischiocavernosus muscle could potentially help the increase intracavernosal pressure to improve the rigidity of the erection. By teaching relaxation of the pelvic floor and possibly performing manual release of the muscle through internal release, blood flow can improve and thereby it will improve the erectile function. Additionally, pelvic floor muscle training, there are various pelvic floor muscle training program, but I preferred, or I have recently found in the literature, it was given by Hodges et al. Have proposed a specific training program to optimize pelvic floor muscle function in the treatment of incontinence post-prostatectomy, means removal of the prostate gland. Additional consideration to optimize result. Pelvic floor rehabilitation is not a passive intervention, and to see improvements, patients need to adhere to the exercise. Any bowel dysfunction must be managed as this negatively impacts the pelvic floor and the bladder. Additional videos and podcasts we can use, any issues of the mental health must be addressed. General exercise is very important and has been shown to improve outcomes. Weight loss is important in overweight men as obesity has been linked to poor outcomes. Now this is the end of my lecture, and this is the references. If you have any question, you can contact me. And if you want any link or any type of articles which is stated in the references, you can contact me.